This is the structure of abstract factory pattern. We'll see how this is implemented in Ruby source. Here is the class abstract factory. It has method createProduct1. This must be defined in subclass. Otherwise, if it is used, then it will throw error. And here is the method createProduct2. This method must be defined in subclass. Otherwise, if it is used, then it will throw error. Here is the subclass concreteFactory1 derived from abstractFactory. And here it implements the method createProduct1. Inside this, it creates the product1_1 object and returns it. And here is the implementation of method createProduct2. Inside this, it creates the object of product2_1 and returns it. So we can see concreteFactory1 is creating series1 product. product1_1 and 2_1. Here is the subclass concreteFactory2 derived from abstractFactory, and here it implements the method createProduct1. Inside this, it creates the object of product1_2 and returns it. And here it implements the method createProduct2. Inside this, it creates the object of product2_2 and returns it. So we can see concreteFactory2 is creating object of series2 product, product1_2 and product2_2. Here is the class abstractProduct1, and it has method display. This method must be defined in subclass, otherwise if it is used, then it will throw error. And here is the subclass product1_1 derived from abstractProduct1, and here it implements the method display. Inside this, it is just displaying this statement. And here is the subclass product1_2 derived from abstractProduct1, and here it implements the method display. Inside this, it is just displaying this statement. And here is the class abstractProduct2. It has method display. This method must be defined in subclass. Otherwise, if it is used, then it will throw error. And here is the subclass product2_1 derived from abstractProduct2. And here it implements the method display. Inside this, it is just displaying this statement. And here is the subclass product2_2 derived from abstractProduct2, and here it implements the method display. Inside this, it is just displaying this statement. Okay, we will see how all these classes are used. So here we are creating object of concreteFactory1, and we are assigning it to variable factory1. And then we are calling the method createProduct1 of factory1, which is pointing to concreteFactory1 object, and the returned value is assigned to variable prod1. So when the method createProduct1 of factory1 is called, so it will go to concreteFactory1 createProduct1. So it will come here, it will create product1_1 object, and it will return it. So product1_1 object is assigned to variable prod1. So when the method display is called, it will go to product1_1 display. So it will come here and it will display this statement. Similarly, here method createProduct2 of factory1 is called. So it will go to concrete factory 1, create product 2. So it will come here and it will create the product 2 underscore 1 object, and that object will be returned. So product 2 underscore 1 object will be assigned to variable prod2, and when the method display is called, it will go to product 2 underscore 1 display. So it will come here and it will display this statement. So we can see, using these statements with concrete factory 1, we are creating series 1 products. And here we are creating series 2 products using these statements. So first we are creating concrete factory 2 object, and we are assigning to variable factory 2. And then we are calling the method create product 1 of factory 2. Factory 2 is pointing to concrete factory 2 object. So it will go to concrete factory 2 create product 1. So it will come here and it will create product 1 underscore 2 object, and the returned object will be assigned to variable prod 1. So you can see product 1 underscore 2 object is assigned to prod 1. So when the method display is called, it will go to product 1 underscore 2 display. So it will come here and it will display this statement. And similarly, here the method create product 2 of factory 2 is called. So it will go to concrete factory 2 create product 2. So it will come here, and here it is creating product 2 underscore 2 object, and that object is assigned to variable prod 2. So when the method display is called, it will go to product 2 underscore 2 display. So it will come here and it will display this statement. Okay, we will run this program and we will see the output. Okay, so when the method display is called here, this statement is returning product 1 underscore 1 object, create product 1 of concrete factory 1. This is product 1 underscore 1 object. So it is going here, and inside product 1 underscore 1 display. Similarly, when the method display is called here, it goes to product 2 underscore 1 display, because this create product 2 of concrete factory 1 is returning product 2 underscore 1 object. So product 2 underscore 1 display is displaying this statement inside product 2 underscore 1 display. Similarly, here when the method display is called, it will go to product 1 underscore 2 display, as create product 1 of concrete factory 2 is returning product 1 underscore 2 object. So when the method display is called here, it goes to product 1 underscore 2 display, and this is display. Similarly, when the method display is called here, it goes to product2_2display. As here create product 2 of concrete factory 2 is returning product2_2 object here. So it goes to this display, will go to product2_2display, and it will display this. So we can see we are using concrete factory 1 for creating series 1 products, and we are using concrete factory 2 for creating series 2 products.